Tell me how much money the practice has brought in this quarter.
After expenses, this is how much your practice has netted.
Oh my God, that's a
How is that possible?
It's a negative number.
What?
You have more money going out than you have coming in. It's as simple as that.
How did this happen?
Well, you spent most of your revenue on something called the Later Baby Launch Party.
Nobody came because someone wrote Rikers Island by accident on the invitation. It was me.
If you don't get more patients in immediately, your practice will definitely go under.
If we wanted predictions in the future, we'd go to my psychic, Lady Mysterioso. Yes. We pay you for accounting advice.
Actually, you haven't paid me in months, which is the other reason I'm here.
Did you see this negative number? I just learned what that meant.
Can you just take your money out of this?
Hold that leg rope.
Every day since I've been in this camp, white folks shot and stabbing on each other, still walking around to do their business.
Maybe we could too.
Not only is violence we meant was to that stallion's prick, and then to turn an honest dollar. I was coming to find you once I had the horse clean. This is the horse that hurt your boy. We collected him and we brung him back.
He died.
The horse escaped in my care. You may hold the boy's dying against me. I collected the horse and brought him back. I'm back too. You say what you think is right.
Not gonna act against you for an accident.
Boy. I'm as sorry as I can be. I hope you would take that to his mother for me. I was answerable to the horse that trampled his boy. Camp being stirred up. If I lingered to make my arrangements, I don't think I would have lived to catch that horse.
Ain't that the purest form of nigger logic? He runs, he blames the white man, and then he comes back, and he treats him like dirt. Hey, when can I start working for you, you f***ing monkey ape? Why don't you start jumping up and down and pounding your chest?
You old fight! Ah. You put me down until you're ready to kill me or run.
You're gonna leave this to me. Do you understand? You leave it to me.
I came my part, and he wouldn't meet me.
I'll take care of it. Will you let me try? That's what I want for my son.
Put me down.
If I do, it won't be to kill you, and I'm not running. So what are we gonna do then?
Put me down.
What's your thing?
Well, okay, look at this.
Family's going
you see where you
times.
Put your arm around
our
Marcus
family.
You did that right as you were saying the words, our family. I'm just thinking, it could seem, possibly to some, that you were presenting Marcus as your son.
That's so very stupid, I don't know where to begin.
Well, I'm not saying definitely,
I have taken pictures with millions of fans all over this country with my arm around them in that exact same pose, and do you think people assume that each one of them is my child?
No.
What is it? But you want to be in a commercial?
No.
Well, then if I were you, I would start worrying more about sales and less about whether or not people think Marcus is my son, because anybody that looks at that commercial and thinks that is an idiot.
Let me stop you, Joyce. That is not Owen in the commercial. Oh, it seems like it, huh? But of course it's not. I mean, you know Owen. You know our son. Well, he's much heavier. You've seen him. He's overweight. I'll talk to you later.
Colonel. Job well done.
Just call me Dad.
Hey, what do you say we go get the trophy?
Yeah! Yeah!
Listen to me, Tommy Gunn. You can't fight the press. I can't fight the dog with the press. And as long as they got Balboa on the brain, he'll always be champ. The man fought wars in the ring.
Tommy, face facts. You're in his shadow. I don't know if there's any way out.
Man, this is your old man talking.
No. Listen to me. There's a way for you to get the respect you deserve, but what you got to do is challenge Balboa to fight man to man.
That's right. Georgia can set this fight up abroad in a matter of weeks.
Yeah, it'd be the greatest fight ever. Teacher against student, old lion against young lion. And it's the only way you ever gonna get peace of mind, because believe me when I tell you, that press is gonna hound you with that man's legend for as long as you dare to wear boxing gloves. You gotta get him into that ring, Tommy Gunn, or you gonna be in question like you heard tonight for the rest of your life. Then you gonna start to ask yourself, could I really take him? Am I really good enough? Do people really think I'm a cheap carbon copy or a second-rate pretender who only got a shot because of my skin tone?
Only in America.
Hey, Rock! Y'all classed the bomb, huh?
Touch me and I'll sue.
Come on, Pug. Touch me and I'll sue.
Sue me for what?